Good morning to everybody. Now today, we are start our next lecture on our design of flange coupling. In previous lecture, we can discuss about the numerical on clamp coupling. Today we are the see design of clamp coupling as well as the numerical on flange coupling. Okay. So, in the flange coupling, you can start your flange coupling with your numerical. So first we can see the figure of flange coupling on your screen, as well as after the figure of flange coupling you can see the numerical on design of flange coupling. So you can check your screen also, or the you can write down also. Design a cast iron protective flange coupling to transmit 15 kW at 900 rpm from an electric motor to a compressor. The service factor may be assumed as 1.35. The following permissible stresses may be used: shear stress for shaft, bolt and key material is 40 MPa, and crushing stress for bolt and key is 80 MPa, and the shear stress for the cast iron is 8 MPa. You can see complete problem on the screen. Then we can see one by one. First, what is your given conditions? First one is given is P. P is 15 kW. So it's 15 into 10^3 right. Then speed is N. N is 900 rpm. Then service factor. Service factor is 1.35. Then shear stress for the shaft, shear stress for the bolt, and shear stress for the key. That is your 40 MPa, it means 40 Newton per mm square. Then crushing stress for the bolt and crushing stress for the key, that is your 80 MPa, it means 80 Newton per mm square. Then shear stress for the cast iron, so tau is equal to 8 MPa, it means 8 Newton per mm square. Then after that you can design one by one. So first one is your design of hub. In the design of hub, the torque transmitted by the shaft, that is the formula is your P equal to 2π×60. So you can put the value of your P is your 15×10^3 into 2×π×900×T divided by 60. That's why you can also calculate the same problem on the calculator. So the torque is T is 159.15 Newton meter. So you can convert that Newton meter to Newton mm, because the requirement of the shaft is, diameter of the shaft is in mm. So T equal to 159.15 into 10^3 Newton mm. Then you can convert that torque to your maximum torque. So T max equal to 1.35 into T. So it's 1.35 into 159.15 into 10^3. So that's why you can calculate your T max, and T max is your 214.85 into 10^3 Newton mm. That is the first one. You can calculate your T max. After that, you can check this torque or calculating your diameter of hub, or the diameter of hub. So T equal to 5/16 into tau into d cube. So that's why 214.85 into 10^3 equal to 5/16 into 14 into d^3. So that's why after calculating your D diameter of shaft, so it's D is 30.39. After that, you can check your design data book. The nearest value of your D is 30.30. So as per your design data book, the diameter of shaft D is your 35 mm. Then after the diameter of hub, next to one, the outer diameter of hub, that is capital D. Capital D is equal to twice small d. It means 2 into 35. So the outer diameter of hub, that is capital D, is 70 mm. After that, length of hub. Length of hub, that is also in terms of diameter. So capital L equal to 1.5 into small d. So it's your 1.5 into 35. So the length of hub, capital L equal to 52.5 mm. Then after that, your diameter of hub, then outer diameter of hub, then length of hub. Next one. Now check the induced shear stress for the your cast iron. Induced shear stress for your cast iron. So T equal to pi by 16 into tau d to the power of 4 minus small d to the power of 4 upon capital D. Why it's use this formula? Due to they can use outer diameter of hub. So the capital D is your outer diameter of hub and your small d is your diameter of shaft or inner diameter of hub. So after that, it's your 214.85 into 10 to the power 3 into equal to pi by 16 into tau into 70 to the power 4 minus 35 to the power 4 upon 70. So that's why your tau shear stress for the cast iron is 3.40 megapascal. But as per your given stress for the cast iron, that is your 8 megapascal, and your calculating value is 3.40. So it's less than of given value. So that is the safe of your design of hub. Design of hub is safe. After that, next one is your design of key. In the design of key, since crushing stress for the key, crushing stress for the key is equal to twice shear stress for the key. It is twice shear stress for the key. Therefore, on design data, small d is your 35 mm, and width of key W equal to 12 mm. Then thickness of key, small d equal to W equal to 12 mm. Then length of hub is equal to length of key. Length of hub is equal to length of key. That is your 52.5 mm, because we have already calculated the length of hub. Then now check the induced stress in the key. Induced stress in the key for shearing and crushing also. So first we can check your shearing stress. So T equal to L into W into tau into D by L. So it's your 214.85 into 10 to the power 3 equal to 52.5 into 12 into tau into 35 by 2. So after calculating your shear stress for the key, that is your 19.48 megapascal. Okay. Next one is the design of key. This is induced for your crushing stress. So T is equal to L into T by 2 into sigma CK into T by 2. So it's 214.85 into 10 to the power 3 equal to 52.5 into 12 by 2 into sigma CK into 35 by 2. So crushing stress is 38.97. So after that, since the initial and threshold stress in the key are less than the permissible stress. Because the given permissible stress is the 40 MPa, and from that, as compared to your 40 MPa, both are the less one. Then, after the design of key, next one is your design of flange. For the design of flange, first one is your thickness of flange. The formula of your thickness of flange, that is TF, TF equal to 0.5D. 0.5 times D. So it's 0.5 into 35. So TF is your 17.5 mm. 17.5 mm. After that, now check the induced shear stress in the flange. So for your flange, T max equal to pi d square by 2. The circumference is your pi d square upon 2 into shear stress for the cast iron into TF. So 214.85 into 9.3 equal to pi into 70 square upon 2 into tau into 17.5. That's why after calculating that, the tau C is your 1.59 MPa. And the given permissible stress for the cast iron, permissible stress of shearing for the cast iron is 8 MPa. Since the new shear stress in the flange is less than 8 MPa, therefore the design of the flange is also the same. After that, you can design a hub, you can calculate the design of hub, design of key, and design of flange. After that, the remaining is your design of bone. For the design of bone, since the diameter of the shaft is 33 mm, so let us take the number of bone, that is your n equal to 3, n equal to 3. So therefore, the pitch circle diameter of hole, that is D1, it is denoted as capital D1, equal to 3 times D, equal to 3 into 35, that's why D1 equal to 105 mm. The bolts are subjected to shear, the shear stress due to the torque transmitted, that's why T max equal to pi by 4 into D1 square into tau B into N into D1 by 2. That's why it's your 214.85 into 10^3 equal to pi by 4 D1 square into 40 into N number of bolts, we can use 3 into 105 by 2. That's why small D1 means diameter of bolt, it's your 6.58. Then the outer diameter of the flange, that is capital D2 equal to 4 times D. So it's 4 into 35. So D2 is your 140 mm. And the thickness of protective circumference of flange, so it's your TP, and TP is 0.25 times D. So 0.25 into 35. So it's 8.75. So TP is 8.75, so approximately you can convert it to 10 mm, so TP is your 10 mm. So now we can stop here, it's the problem of design of flange. On next lecture, we can discuss about next problem. Thank you.